You're a bunch of crooks and you know it, and you're gonna get caught, you hear me? The coppers are coming and you better head over the loot.
Nah, 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 nah.
Well, this is getting a little tiring, I must say. But I think I've proved my point. That M&M is a boring sim and that's why nobody goes there. I'm a shareholder! Hello! Is that common practice to ban shareholders from the sim?
I really didn't mean it. Hello? Hello? Can someone say sorry? I didn't mean it. Seriously. Kind of. Sort of. In a nice kind of way. I do suspect you of something. I know you've done something very naughty. And other people are gonna find out about it, you know. You better give them their money back. They deserve it, you know. Hello, M&M. I want to be a star. Why won't you listen to me? Oh,
that's because the sim's so empty. No one's there. There's never anybody there.
And why? Because it's a front! That's why! You're all fools to believe! Don't believe! You're being fooled! I'm telling you. It's a front. I know it is. I can see it with my own eyes. Look, over there. It's M&M. Synergy Island! In Second Life! It's a front! For another damn scam! I'm okay. I'll just stand here having a few cocktails while I wait. Oh, see, I got my bottle here. Don't worry about me. I'll be alright. It's my nice bottle of whiskey, Jack Daniels. He's my friend. I know Jack likes me. Oh, boy, here I go. I'm so sorry. Forgive me. They took the money and ran. Those nasty little people. How would you like to get a buck back a year on 15 grand? You better hand over the loot or else. They took the money and ran. Those nasty little people.
Does this pop into anybody's mind? Does it ring a bell?
Okay, I'm leaving now. I think I'm proving my point. It's alright. You guys can have your sim. I don't want your sim. Your sim sucks.
Wait, you're gonna see. I'm gonna get you guys. I'm gonna tell everybody about you and no one's gonna wanna play with you. So there. And I hope someone's been listening to me, because I think I've proven my point, because I'm going to put it on YouTube and make a fool of myself. But in the process, it's going to be making a fool of M&M, because they're all going to know what fools you are and what lies and thieves you are. You took your investors' money, told them you were going to create a great company in Second Life, and create a real-life business along the boot. You took all their money, and once the IPO money was all there, you took it out. And then later, in April, you decided to have somebody else take over and tell us to break the news gently that the investors in Second Life wouldn't profit with the own damn money they invested into the real-life company. Who's fooling who, you idiots? Do you think we're that stupid? If anybody is really listening, don't invest in companies in Second Life that say they're going to open up a real-life business and take your dough and run because you can't trace it. It's
it's a bunch of bullshit and you know it! It's criminal! It's internet fraud! You'll pay! People will know! You put it into your own personal avatar, well what did you do with it then? Did you transfer it out through Linden Lab? Or did you do it some other smooth way? Did you spread it among a bunch of avatars? Hello, avatars over there, I can see you. Give it up! Tell me how you did it! Did you spread it amongst yourselves? You all have a bunch of alts, I'm sure. You're all in on it. You're all a bunch of crooks. And the crooks won't stop, so if anybody's listening, I love Second Life, and I love the people in it, but there are a bunch of crooks here. And you better wake up, because it's going to go on and on if somebody doesn't say anything. And this is a good example. I hope you've learned your lesson. I don't know how many husbands and wives know that their family members that are on Second Life are spending all kinds of money, thousands of dollars, real life dollars, handing it over to these schmucks who say they're going to rule the metaverse with, and they do absolutely nothing for the people that gave them the money. They're going to give it back. It was like a loan, a free loan. That's what they did. They took the investors' money. After the IPO was completed, the CEO transferred the funds directly to her private personal avatar and cashed out what she could. Used it to invest into the real life company. The very money the Second Life resident investors gave them to invest into a Second Life real life company, thinking they would profit from it. But that was a bunch of crap. People are gonna say it. Yep, I made a fool of myself, but at the expense of what? To expose you bullies? You're a bunch of crooks and you know it. Why did I pick on you? Because I've had enough. All the others, you know who you are. You're laughing all the way to the bank at the expense of some stupid resident sucker. So what I'm trying to do here is expose you, and it's just not right anymore. You've taken too much money from Second Life residents, these stock exchanges, people with these little schemes thinking that they're going to convince investors that they're going to make all kinds of money. I've had enough. And it's gonna stop. You better send the money back. You got a free loan. No interest. People caught on to you now. Too many people have been taken in Second Life from these Second Life stock exchanges. This is a grand example of that. They've been promised the world. They were promised a company to invest in that they would benefit from. They put up an IPO. It closed. The CEO took the money, withdrew it from Linden Lab, from Second Life, invested it into who knows. How can you trace that? There aren't any traces. You're a bunch of liars and you know it, and you've been exposed and you're trying to correct it, but you're not doing a good job of it.